quickly did it come about?
Came really quickly. General Catalyst actually preempted our round, so I think it shows the how hot AI and robotics is at the moment.
Okay, does this feel like slowly all at once? Because I'm pretty sure you've been at this for quite a while, and already you've had your robotic arms in companies.
That's exactly right. I think it's a moment in time where we realize this is happening.
Evan, really grateful to have you on the show. I want to go into those strategics. You know, we've done a lot on this program about Amazon, robotics in the warehouse. Samsung, like, I guess, is the opportunity down the line in the manufacturing context? What are you kind of hoping for there?
Yeah, so we realized a few years ago we can make an American-made robot that's easier to use, more affordable, and most importantly, capable of performing many more tasks than other robots out there. Most robots today, they have this rigid programming that's sort of like code, something that resembles code. And so we're focused on this new paradigm where you just demonstrate the task that you want the robot to perform, and then it can learn how to perform that from the demonstration autonomously.
So we're just showing some pictures of the technology we're talking about. We're not talking about humanoid robots. We're talking about cutting edge of robotic arms, essentially. Why is yours better than the rest? We've had some similar things on the show, Evan.
Yeah, I think we don't need to create legs and a torso to make a huge impact. So our approach is we make a device, and this device, it's sort of like scissors, but it can grip instead of cutting. And you can show how to assemble something, show how to, you know, prepare food, what have you. And it learns from that demonstration. And we think our approach with this device, it's a much quicker way to market than the humanoids, and it's going to make a really big impact. And we can take it to market this year. We already are with some really big customers.
Look, how hard is this? What sort of academic affiliations are you having to have? How much are you having to push forward innovation with the funding that you've got? Is this now about hiring talent? Is it about expanding here in New York?
Yeah, it's definitely hard. We've got an amazing team, so they really get all the credit. But we've hired from places like Cruise, Waymo, Rivian, Meta. So we've got the best of the best on the team. We really think this can make a really big impact in the world. So that drives our team, and it's a lot of fun too. So
I mean, spell out the mission here. Because many who are working in manufacturing might be like, well, that's my job. So ultimately, what is the net positive outcome that you want from this business that drives all the people to want to leave Rivian and other key companies to come to you?
Yeah, actually, we have industry stats show over the next few years a shortage of 2 million workers. So there's it's not so much replacing jobs as we have this huge shortage. And we really think that you know, most of the products we buy are not made in the U.S., or many of them aren't. And so if we can bring back manufacturing, that actually creates jobs. And it's better for national security. It's better for the environment to produce where we use the items. And these kind of productivity boosts, they really lower the cost of food and other items for people who can't afford them the most. So we think it's really important work. They're going to have a large positive impact. And you know, there's a huge shortage right now in jobs, so I think people can rest assured.
I've listened to Jensen Huang talk about the biggest opportunities to be unlocked by what's happening in large language models, and robotics is front and center for him. What I find interesting is your scale and your location in New York. So talk to me about building the company, talent. Is the money you've raised enough? Walk us through the roadmap of the next couple of years.
Yeah, we're bringing this to market this year in a big way. Talent is I think this is like a really, really fun, other than being a TV anchor like you, Ed, this is one of the most fun things you can work on right now in tech. So it hasn't been that hard to attract amazing talent, and I think the mission-oriented focus of the company helps to attract amazing talent as well. But we're going to continue to need amazing people. We've doubled our team in the last 12 months. Our robot orders have gone up 20x in the last year. So we're really experiencing a lot of growth. We're trying to hire to handle the growth and the orders, and we're very excited about the future.